Good morning, students. So today we are going to start the chapter. This is chapter number 2. The name of the chapter is What is Democracy and Why? So what is democracy and why? Children, we all know what is democracy. Now I have written a very simple definition which is given in your book in chapter number 2. It will be easy for you to understand if you just see your book and listen the video. So whatever I written, I'm reading it out. Democracy is the form of government where people elect rulers. So whatever I written, democracy is the form of government where people elect rulers. That means that this is such form of government where people are the one to elect the rulers. ये एक ऐसी गवर्नमेंट फॉर्म है जहाँ पर लोग रूलर्स को इलेक्ट करते हैं. नाउ व्हेन वी से दिस सिंपल डिफाइन, सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस अराइज इन आवर माइंड एंड दीज क्वेश्चंस आर जनरल क्वेश्चंस. एज फॉर एग्जांपल, व्हेन आई से डेमोक्रेसी इज द फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, सो व्हेन आई से फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, सो व्हाट फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, दिस क्वेश्चन आई पुट ऑन अ क्वेश्चन मार्क. वेयर पीपल, नाउ व्हिच पीपल एम आई टॉकिंग अबाउट. Which people? People refers to whom? Are they common people or somebody else? Who can give rise to the form of government? Election. Elect rulers. So we elect rulers by the process of election. So what is election? Is the election general election? Or it should be fair and fine? Or is it fair or not? That we will discuss in this video. And last, who are the rulers which we are found to be elected? So the rulers, who are they? That is what we shall discuss in this particular video right now. So form of the government. If I talk about form of the government, that means democracy is totally free. Now, when democracy is a form of government where the people are the one to elect the rulers, that means you are the one to cast vote. Now, when you are the one to cast the vote, that means election procedure is going on. Now, when election procedure is going on, then how can you say that this is free and fair and this is fully democratic? So, let us discuss election first. Is it fair or not? That we shall discuss by an example of Pakistan, which is there in your book. Now, who are the rulers? The rulers, they are the one who are being elected after being vote. जब हम vote कहते हैं उसके बाद जो elect होकर representatives आते हैं, that we say as rulers. So now let us discuss the people. The people, they are the common citizens of the country, but everybody doesn't have the right to vote. Nowadays, 18 year plus or 18 years, if a person becomes, then he or she has a right, or he or she becomes eligible to vote. And so many pros and cons are there that will you be given the right to vote or not. Suppose you are a criminal person, so in certain cases if you do not have sound mind, if your mind is not sound, then you won't be given voting rights. So the people, they are the common citizen. That is what we have studied in this particular chapter we are going to study. So let us move further. Before moving further, let me say about election. When can you say that it is free and fair? Free and fair, that means there is no malpractice. There is no malpractice. Now malpractice, that means in Hindi we say dhokadadi. So there is no malpractice over here, then that election is said to be free and fair. That means you have not used monetarily anything to win the elections, or you have not undergone any malpractices to win the election or the seat or to come in power. Then only you can say the election to be free and fair. Now there is one example related to this, and this is an example of China. We know that in China the elections are found to be old. Regularly. Now I'm grabbing this. Let me talk about election now. So I'm grabbing the define also, and I'm talking. China. We all know that in China, single party is found to be ruling, and it is a communist party which is continuously ruling. Now, for an election to be free and fair, at least you need more than two parties. They need to contest elections. The election should be free and fair. There should not be malpractice. It should not be like that, that the party is trying to overpower the another one. So if we take an example, and it will be easy for us to understand this free and fair election by an example of China. So what has gone in China, children, that in China the elections are found to be held regularly, even after every 5 years. And we find that National People's Congress, it is found to be coming into power. And it comes into power to appoint the president of the country. So when it comes into power to appoint the president of the country, it is every time coming into power. And it has nearly 3,000 members elected from all over the China. So before contesting an election, a candidate needs the approval of the Chinese Communist Party. So one single party here in China, that is said to be Chinese Communist Party, which is found to be winning the elections in regularity. And is it possible that a single party is going to win again and again? No. It is not at all possible if a country is democratic. And if you have number of parties, more than two or two parties, maybe two or more than two, more than. More than I said, because number of parties are more, it becomes more democratic. So is it possible that every time one single party is found to be winning? It is not at all possible, but this is possible in the case of China, and we find the Chinese Communist Party to be coming into power every time. So we cannot call China to be a democracy or a pure democracy, you can say, or it is not democratic. So we can say that China is not democratic. It is pretending to be democratic. It is pretending to be democratic. Now let us take an example of Pakistan also. I'm going to take an example of Pakistan and then discuss about democracy. So before that, let us proceed with universal adult franchise. Now what is this? It's of great importance if a country is democratic. So universal adult franchising means one vote, one person, one vote, and each vote has equal value. Either it be a vote of a poor person, either it be a vote of a rich person, each and every vote is going to count equal. So that is what is universal adult franchising. And it needs to be there, granted to each and every citizen if a country is truly democratic. Now let me move to Pakistan. When Pakistan was being ruled by Parvez Musharraf, let me talk on the topic that, so can we call Pakistan to be a democratic country when it was under the rule of Parvez Musharraf? No, I don't think so that we can call Pakistan to be a democratic country. So when Pakistan, let us consider it. So what happened in Pakistan? So in Pakistan, I'm talking about General Parvez Musharraf. So what did he do? So we are talking about General Parvez Musharraf, and he was the one to lead a military coup. What did he organize? He organized a military coup So in Pakistan, General Pervez Musharraf, he was the one to organize a military coup. And it was in the year 1999, October. So when did he do so? He did so in October 1999. Okay. So Pakistan, we are studying a case of Pakistan in October 1999, when General Pervez Musharraf, he was the one to lead a military coup. And he was the one to overthrow the democratically elected government, and he became a chief executive. So he was the one to overthrow the democratically elected government, and he announced that I'm the chief executive. And later on, he changed his designation, and he then called himself to be the president. So you know, have that designation changed earlier. For example, you know very well that in your school, teachers are there, principal is there. So when we use the word principal, that is a designation for the person. So General Pervez Musharraf, he changed his designation from chief executive to president. Now, after being so in 1999, and when 2002 came, so 1999, from 1999, if you go to 2002, if you are going to 2002, so it is 5 years, so one goes is debit vote, he could have debit vote, second is indirect vote. So in 2002, he was about to the elder D. Frender. D. Frender. So General Pervez Musharraf in 2002, he wanted to extend his power. And in 2002, he held a referendum in the country. Referendum, referendum. And he held a referendum. So let us talk about what is referendum. Referendum, that is direct vote. Suppose you are going in directly and you are asking a person, are you ready to accept me as a king? Or are you ready to accept me as a president for further 5 years? Because we know that for 5 years the things go on in democracy. So he just called a referendum because he was quite sure that he is going to gain the power. The people are going to say yes for him. So those are the only referendum held out here. And it was very clear. He got yes for the answer, and as a result, from 2002 to 2007, he was found to be the president of Pakistan. Now, was it in reality that the referendum was not undergone any malpractices and he was the one to win the referendum? No, it was not like that. He laid a control on Pakistani media. If I talk about Pakistani media, if I talk about human rights organization, if I talk about democracy activists, then they said that the referendum which Pervez Musharraf has won, that was all based on malpractices. So we get one new word, that is malpractice. I'm writing the word over here. Malpractice. Malpractice, in Hindi we call it vocabulary, that is using wrong measures to win the referendum, and that was being done by Pervez Musharraf. In actual, how did he win this referendum? How did he win? So in 2002, he was the one to pass out. He passed an act. He passed an act. And this act was legal framework order it was. Yes. Legal framework order. Now what is legal framework order? This is what we need to understand now. So you have understood what is referendum. Referendum, that is direct vote. You are going and asking, are you ready to accept me? If the people say yes, then it is yes. If they say no, then you lose your power. So now the question arises that when media is raising a question on you, and rather than that, not only media, but at the same time, the human rights organization, which is of utmost importance, is raising a question on you, that this referendum is not at all correct, it is all based on malpractice. So it now comes to our mind, if we recall that what happened in 2002 when he was the president to the country Pakistan. So at that time he passed an act, and that act is legal framework order. Now we are going to study, children, what is legal framework order. Now legal framework
first part, it increased the power of president. Increased power of president. And he got the right to it.
So this increased the power of the president when this act was passed out. And according to this order, the president could dismiss the national and the provincial assemblies. Now, what is a national assembly and a provincial assembly? National assembly, as we have central government, that is national assemblies. And provincial assembly, as we call state, state assemblies. So that is provincial assembly. So he was a, this act gave the right to Parvez Musharraf that he could disband both the assemblies, that is the national assembly and the provincial assemblies. So the work of the civilian cabinet was supervised by National Security Council and it was dominated by military officers. So the dominancy ultimately went to Parvez Musharraf and he was not directly elected. He won by referendum. Kya wo direct elect ho kar aaya tha? Nahi, direct elect ho kar nahi aaya tha. Election hua tha? Nahi hua tha. Voting hui thi? No. Nothing was there. It was a direct election. So how can we say that Parvez Musharraf was directly, directly elected by the election? In actual, he was directly elected leader, non-directly elected leader, and he came into power. So once when he came to power and he was about to issue the order, तो क्या हम उस country को उस समय के शासनकाल में जब परवेज मुशर्रफ was about to rule over, can we call it democratic? No. Pakistan can never be called democratic in this case because the whole sole power of taking decisions was with military, was with Parvez Musharraf, and he was not directly elected. Thank you today.